Now, there's not many riders that are going through and contributing to the work on the front of this group. However, the riders that are very committed and are very strong.
37 riders in the group. That is enormous. And if the information is correct, the race computer indicating that Jai Hindley is in the move with two teammates, Emmanuel Bookman and Patrick Conrad. But I haven't spotted any of them. They still could be there hiding at the back, trying to slip through under the radar.
The young American riding for Movistar, as we mentioned, he would have come here thinking he was supporting Enric Mas in his ambitions for a top 10 or even top 5 placing in the general classification. But these climbs will suit Jorgensen.
Jai Hindley is in the group. I have just spotted him. So Hindley has made it into the move. Smart move by Jai Hindley. He's the rider now in third position. He wants to follow the moves but not waste any energy. And he's called Wout van Aert into second spot behind Giulio Ciccone. Esteban Chavez with the yellow and pink helmet trying to come across.
Well, Hindley also has a teammate there, the German national champion, the white jersey. That's Bookman. That looks like Nielands there from AG2R. Pardon me.
From Israel Premier Tech.
Thank
He's
you.
Got the red sleeve, the blue sleeve. I like this. Again, we see this, Bridie, from Jai Hindley. He's dropping another spot back to be behind his teammate, Emmanuel Bookman. It is the Tour de France. It is the biggest bike race on the planet, the biggest annual sporting event in the world. And they're about to go over what is the biggest categorization of a climb in the Tour de France, all category. It's outside categorization. 20 points for first place over the top. And it is Felix Gaul who collects maximum points, and he moves into the lead in the race for the polka dot jersey as the leader of the King of the Mountains classification. Bookman, Ciccone wants points. So does Danny Martinez. The sprint is on for second. Martinez collects them.
And once again, Hindley playing it safe, keeping in contact. He wants to go over the descent with these other riders. He doesn't want to descend on his own, but he wasn't trying to expend any additional energy to try and fight for second place over that KOM.
Jack Hay comes through. Then it's Jorgensen, Betiol, Omar Frehley. Next in line is Madouas. For the level of exertion for you two to see Jai Hindley in that breakaway by comparison to Vingegaard, Pogacar and Yates within the main peloton, how much more energy is he spending out in front, or is he not?
Well, in my opinion, I just hope he's not spending too much nervous energy by being out there. He's definitely not working much harder physically than the big favourites that are still back in the peloton, because he's been riding conservatively. He's been up the front when it's mattered to go over the summit of the climbs. He's been well placed for the descent. But once we've gotten into the valleys where the breakaway are working much harder, he's been drifting to the back of the group and conserving energy. So in my opinion, he hasn't used up too much energy at this point in time, but I just hope he hasn't wasted too much nervous energy by being up there thinking about what could eventuate today.
The peloton hit the base of the climb. Their deficit, it is 2:54 to the leaders with Alaphilippe, Nielands and van Aert. It is 2:45 to the group containing Manuel Bookman, Jai Hindley, Danny Martinez, Giulio Ciccone, Juanpe Lopez, Mühlberger, then Jorgensen, Jack Haig, Madouas, Rigoberto Urán. This is Wout van Aert. Has lost contact with the group. Has he been dropped or has he been called back?
I think he's been called back. We could just see, you know, suddenly he went from being off the front to out the back. So I think that's a clear message that's come from Jumbo Visma, that he can sit back, come back. I think Jonas, he needs a couple extra teammates.
And he was on the radio.
Well, AG2 are doing a really good job here of keeping the pace high. They obviously want to get Gala as far up the climb as possible before he makes his move. And there he goes.
That's just like a lead out. Just one by one, they're just doing a straight peel, aren't they?
Now, Gala making his move. Hard on the wheel is Jai Hindley. Hindley looking really good. Nice light gear, setting into a rhythm.
So on the first of the big climbs today, the Col du Soudé, when there was the attack from Felix Gaul, Hindley didn't respond. He just rode conservatively. Maitre didn't go into the red zone. Now he responds. Now he goes. This is an opportunity for yellow.
It's going to be really interesting to see how he approaches this climb, whether he just goes all in this final 4 kilometres from here. It's just only going to get steeper and steeper. So we need to see Hindley's game plan here.
And Jai Hindley now puts his cards on the table. The poker face is off. The game face is on. Yellow jersey and the stage victory. Two big objectives for the day. Gross, Shatner, Micah, Pogacar, Yates, Wilco Kelderman, Jonas Vingegaard, Egan Bernal and Carlos Rodriguez still in the group. This too is starting to thin out. Jai Hindley is on his own. He has ridden away from Felix Gall. Hindley is on a mission. Objective, yellow jersey.
1.7 kilometres to go from the summit here and on some of the steepest ramps here of the Col du Mont Blanc.
Jonas attacks. Pogacar is struggling to respond. The race with a shake-up. Thijs Benoot can't help because last year's winner of the Tour de France is throwing the challenge out early to Tadej Pogacar.
Well, Jonas Vingegaard there, he waited for Tadej Pogacar to look as though he was in difficulty. Now he's made his move. He didn't utilise Thijs Benoot, who was up the road. He blasted straight past. Well, Vingegaard is coming, and he's coming quickly. But as we hit the summit of the climb here, it's Jai Hindley leading the way.
Over the top of the Col du Mont Blanc. It's the Western Australian Jai Hindley. He's the virtual race leader of the Tour de France. The yellow jersey, potentially. The stage victory is within his grasp, but it's a 19.5-kilometre descent. He will not celebrate until he gets across the line. Maximum time gains. That is the objective for Hindley. Stage win awaits. The yellow jersey is sure to be his. An incredible way to make his first appearance at the Tour de France.
450 metres to go for Jai Hindley. What a debut for his tour. At stage 5 in his first tour, he's going to take the stage win.
The spectators are banging the barriers, and they're banging them for the Western Australian. Jai Hindley in his first appearance at the Tour de France. Hindley's the hero, and Hindley is in yellow. Extraordinary. The clock to Jonas, and Bookman is in second spot. He wants to win the sprint for third to take the time bonus for third place and second place away from Jonas Vingegaard. Ciccone's going to help out. He's coming for the back for second place on the stage. Bookman gets over the top. It is Ciccone into second on the stage. Gall in third place. 32 seconds, small gap, potentially at 33 seconds to Jonas Vingegaard. He's gone from boring to entertaining. The early strategy's out the door. This is a new one. And now for the most coveted jersey in world cycling. It is the yellow jersey that rests on the shoulders of the disbelieving Jai Hindley. Yes, Jai, it's real. You wear it on the roads of the Tour de France tomorrow.